In coming days, more than 100 million people in the U.S. will be living under a heat advisory as a brutal heat wave moves into the Midwest and Northeast. A new analysis finds the heat that's been baking the U.S., Mexico, and Europe over the past month would be, quote, virtually impossible without human-caused climate change. It comes from an international group of researchers known as the World Weather Attribution. To help us understand more about this real-time assessment, we're joined by Bernadette Woods Placky. She's the chief meteorologist and director at Climate Central, which is an independent group of scientists and communicators. Bernadette Woods Placky, so good to have you on the NewsHour. This new report is part of a field of what's known as attribution science. Can you tell us a little bit about what this study showed about the connection between climate change and these heat events?
So attribution science is where we can go into individual weather events and tease out the role of climate change. We do that through three ways. One, our knowledge of a specific weather event, and heat is one where we know a lot. Two, historic temperature records. We can go back in time to see what's happened before. And three, model data. We can look and we can model different scenarios in our Earth's environment. And when we bring down our levels of carbon dioxide or bring those up, we see changes in that. And when we put all of that together, we have what's called attribution science, and we get our confidence in whether we could recreate this event or not.
And that's what this report seemed to indicate, that it was impossible for these heat waves to be as long and as severe absent climate change.
Correct. And sadly, that's not surprising. We know when we add more heat to our atmosphere through the burning of fossil fuels, that that translates into bigger, stronger heat events, which is the foundation for all of the climate changes that we see.
And is it simply a factor of the fact that this is a warmer atmosphere and we see warmer events? Is that how the mechanism works, or is it more complicated than that?
So it doesn't mean every single place is getting the extreme heat all the time. We're still going to have weather. But when we really raise that platform to a different level where we start with our heat and you add additional heat into the whole Earth system, it's going to play out more intensely and more frequently with these big heat events.
The reason I ask this is that every time we do a story like this, the critics always say, well, oh, it's hot in summertime, how surprising. So how can we really tease out the distinctions between summer weather and climate change?
It is always hotter in the summer than it is in the winter, correct? But certain summers are hotter than others. And what we're talking about right now is record after record after record after record. So you have to look at the pattern. It's not just one individual event in one season. We are looking at southern parts of Europe, a lot of North America and Mexico, China, all at the same times, right? So that's a lot of the globe spiking records like we've never experienced before. And this continues to happen.
We're also entering the period of El Niño, which can warm the oceans and change the weather. Remind us what El Niño is all about and how that might be playing into this.
So El Niño is a natural phenomenon that happens in the Pacific, where we warm our, well, the waters are warmed naturally, and that changes some of our weather patterns around the globe. It also adds additional heat to the atmosphere. So when we get El Niño years, there's a boost in our global temperatures. The thing is, when you want to look at the big picture once again, our El Niño years of current years are breaking records, and they're well above our El Niño years of the past.
I want to ask you about some of the solutions here. I mean, we know that we have to drastically reduce our emissions to stop this human contribution to climate change. But as your organization well knows, and as you strive to try to overcome, getting this change implemented is very, very difficult. Do you believe that this current series of records falling globally, as you described, is going to be able to move the needle in any meaningful way?
People are understanding more and more the connection between what we're experiencing and climate change. The thing is, the warming is just happening faster than our responses. So two things are happening at once. There are some amazing solutions happening and being implemented around our country and around the globe. But we've waited a long time to implement those solutions, so our warming curve is faster. What we need to do is bend that warming curve, and that's where it gets really interesting. Yes, we baked in a certain amount of warming already. However, this isn't per se the new normal. This is a changing normal. We're still in a path to even hotter unless we make those changes. So it is upon us to make those changes so we can limit that future warming.
And how confident are you that we're going to do that? I mean, the reason I ask is that we have had 30 years of international negotiations to address this, and very little to show for that. Emissions keep going up, temperatures keep going up.
They do. It is frustrating. And especially when you follow this daily and this is your world, that is frustrating. However, we do know a couple of things that do help people stay focused on a future of this. One, if you take us back pre the Paris Agreement, we were on a path to say 5-6 degrees Celsius of warming, right? What we're experiencing right now, just for perspective, is 1.2 degrees Celsius of warming. With the implementations and the changes we've made in the world, that 5 or 6 degrees of warming has come down. It really has. It's come down closer to like a 3. If you squeeze out all of the commitments, it could be a 2. There's a range in there. It's not exactly precise. However, it really depends on human behavior. And as we all come together, we've already bent that curve. We just need to accelerate and supersize our actions and bend it even faster.
Bernadette Woods-Placky of Climate Central, thank you so much for being here.
Thanks for having me.